said to you about nuclear power. Okay, this is our group members. Wakidan Muhammad Syafiq bin Rosli, Wakidan Muhammad Syafiq bin Rosli dan Wakidan Muhammad Kumar bin Zulfi. This is our list of contents. First, we go through to our history, uses of nuclear process, of nuclear advantage and disadvantages of nuclear, nuclear power in future, and lastly, is conclusion. Okay, the first slide. The history of nuclear power. The site of atomic radiation, atomic change, and nuclear fission was developed from 118.95 to 109.45, much only in the last years of Brazil. Over 1969 to 45, most development was focused on the atomic bomb. From 1945, attention was given to the harnessing this energy in a controlled fashion for naval propulsion and for making electricity. The final outcome of the MAUD committee was a two summary report in July 1941. One was the uses of uranium for a bomb, and others was on use of uranium as a source of power. What report concluded that is a controlled fission of uranium could be made to provide energy in the form of heat for use in machine as well as providing large quantity of radioisotope which could be used as the substitute of for radium. Since 1956, the prime focus for the technology evolution on renewable nuclear power plant in the USA, Westinghouse designed the first fully commercial power of 250 milliwatt energy, which start up in 1960 and operate in 1992. Meanwhile, the boiling water reactor was developed by Argonne National Laboratory, and the first one of the UWL was developed by ENET. The first one is 250 milliwatt E, designed by General Electric. Was started in 1960. The prototype BWR Felicitas ran from 1957 to 1963. By the end of the 1960s, orders were being placed for PWR and BWR reactor unit of more than 1,000 milliwatt energy.
Okay, for my part, I will explain to you about the uses of nuclear. Here we have four basic concepts on the uses of nuclear power, that is nuclear transport, food and agriculture, electricity and medical application. For the first part, that is nuclear transport, this is the explanation that there are a number of transport modes like ships and submarines which use nuclear-based propulsion. Not for the military, nuclear submarines are the most lethal weapons capable of staying underwater for very long periods, which diesel submarines are incapable of. So for the food and agriculture, we have the radioisotopes and radiations used in food and agriculture. Sterile insect technique, SIT, involves very large numbers of insects when irradiating them with the gamma radiation before hatching to sterilize them. The sterile males are then released in large number in the manifested area. When they mate with females, no offspring are produced. With repeated release of sterile males, the population of the insect males in a given area is drastically reduced. For the electricity, although a nuclear power plant gets its energy for the radioactive materials, many nuclear plants have similarities with fossil fuel plants. Both a nuclear facility and a coal-fired one produce need to boil water into steam. The high-pressure steam turns into a turbine, which in turn power of electrical generator. The steam, turbine, and generator technology is nearly identical in each situation. Using time-tested steam and turbine technology improves the nuclear power plants reliability.
And lastly, for the medical application, nuclear energy finds wide application in medical science, use of nuclear energy for X-ray, chemotherapy, demands is what he knows and accepted. That's all. Next.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I'm Syafiq bin Mazin. Today I want to explain a little bit about process of nuclear reactor. A nuclear reactor is a device used to initiate and control a nuclear chain reaction. Nuclear reactor are used at nuclear power plant for electricity generation and in propulsion of ship. Heat from the nuclear fission is passed to a working fluid such as water or gas, which run through steam turbine and turn the electrical generator. This is the general design of nuclear reactor. This is a reactor vessel, steam generator, turbine, condenser, which we have cooling. And then this is generator for electricity. The core of the reactor contains all the nuclear fuel and generate all the heat. It contains a low-enriched uranium to a control system and a structural material. This is the place where the fissions occur. Next is the coolant. The coolant is the material that passes through the core, transferring the heat from the fuel to a turbine. It could be water, heavy water, liquid sodium, helium or molten salt. In the US fleet of power reactor, water is the standard or mostly coolant that we use. Next is the turbine. The turbine transfers the heat from the coolant to electricity. Just like in a fossil fuel plant, it's the same. Next is the containment. Containment is the structure that separates the reactor from the environment. These are the usually dome shaped, made of high density steel reinforced concrete. In Chernobyl, there do not have containment. That's why there have been a disaster in Chernobyl. And lastly, we have a cooling tower. Cooling tower are needed by some plants to dump to and access the heat that cannot be converted to energy due to the law of thermodynamics. These are the hyperbolic icon of nuclear energy. They emit only clean water vapor. Next, I want to explain the advantage and disadvantage of nuclear power. First, the advantage of nuclear power is low pollution. Nuclear power also has a lot of pure greenhouse emission. It has been determined that the amount of greenhouse gas from nuclear power are decreased by almost half because of the prevalence of in the utilization of nuclear power. And second is low operating cost of nuclear power. Nuclear power produces very inexpensive electricity. The cost of uranium, which is utilized as a fuel in this process, is very low. Also, even through the expenses of setting up the nuclear power, the cost of running them is quite low. Third is reliability. Reliability, it is estimated that with the current rate of consumption uranium, we have enough uranium for another 70 to 18 years. And lastly is the advantage of nuclear power. First is environmental impact, which is one of the biggest issue is the environmental impact in relation to uranium. The process of mining and refining uranium hasn't been a clean process. It actually transporting nuclear fuel to and from plant represents a pollution hazard. Also, once the fuel is used, you can simply take it to landfill. It has a radioactive and very dangerous. Next is nuclear accident. The radioactive waste produced can give serious health effects on the life of people as well as the environment. The Chernobyl accident that occurred in 26 April of 1986 at the Chernobyl nuclear power plant in Ukraine, it was the worst nuclear accident in the history. Its harmful effect on the human and organism can still be seen until today. Next is high cost. The cost of building the power, the nuclear power plant is very high. And lastly is uranium is finite. Just like another source of fuel, uranium is also finite and exists in few of the country. It is pretty expensive to mine, refine and transport uranium. Thank you.
Okay, for the next, topic is nuclear power in the future. When nuclear power is here for now, will new reactor replace phase out reactor in the future? Or will nuclear start to go away, occur and lose out to competition? There are cross looking of both support nuclear future. First is such as the push for clean energy and against lightning cost. One of the proposed solution is a good small modulator reactor. The goal is to simplify the construction process and a mass produce reactor that could be installed with regular equipment, which could save our money throughout the entire process. Unfortunately, however, this idea is still in the concept phase, and it's estimated that it could take more than a decade before this variable option. Then the next one is that again, many reactors in the US won't be due to retire until between 2030 and 2050. Around the world, almost 200 reactors will retire by 2040.
Last but not least, this is our conclusion on the nuclear power. Utilizing nuclear energy is needed if humanity is to continue its advancement. It has great potential to be quite a useful and beneficial part of humanity's growth and development in the decades to come. The problem is when we lose our respect, caution and giving to our naivety and arrogance, a devastating disaster awaits us, and it is collapse in the destructions it causes. It is extremely important that nuclear power plants be held to strict safety standards. Nuclear weapons need to be well maintained and kept secure to prevent disasters. Despite this risk, we should not rule out the use of nuclear fission and potentially nuclear fission in the future as impractical. The ability to treat disease and generate tremendous amounts of electricity with relatively very little fuel is not insignificant. There are applications to science and mankind's future space travels, as well as more diverse applications such as nuclear desalination plant is to create to overlook. As a world, it is imperative that we work to expand the use of nuclear energy, all the while remaining conscious of its destructive potential. Thank you. This is the end of our slide. I hope you enjoy it. Assalamualaikum and goodbye.